Hey guys, welcome to Creative Soft. And Apple just released 14.5, the public version, to all its iOS devices, and you can just get it. So in this particular video, we are going to talk about if it is worth upgrading to 14.5 and what are the new features with the 14.5. So please watch this particular video in the end, because in the end we are going to give our conclusion whether you should update this particular version, that is 14.5, to your iOS devices. And with this, let's get started. So guys, let's check how to install this particular update 14.5. All you need to do is go to the settings app, then click on general, and the second option over here is software update. And if you are new to this channel guys, please consider subscribing and also hit that like button and also press on the bell notification icon. So as you can see over here, the update is almost 1.21 GB for my iPhone 12 mini, and this will definitely vary on the phones which y'all are using, and you know, depending on the updates also which y'all have installed previously. So for example, if y'all are running anything older than 14.4 or any other thing, then definitely this particular update size will vary. And as you can see over here, all you need to do is use and install this using your Wi-Fi, and you need to put the Apple pin over here. Okay, let's also check the total things what we get over here, and this is the complete description of the features which is provided in this particular update. So as you can see over here, the AirTags are there, unlock the iPhone using the face mask, then emojis is there, Siri something new is come, then privacy related application and all these things I'll be talking in details guys, you don't have to worry, and please watch this particular video till the end properly. And as you can see, other things are there, the podcast, the music app, the gaming and translate app, and also Apple CarPlay etc, which I am not being used. So after this update is installed, it will be greeted with this hello particular message, and this is how it looks, and you need to enter the pin. So after all these things, okay, the build number I'll be showing you. So this is the build number 18E199 which have come for my iPhone 12 mini. If you like this kind of videos guys, please hit that like button, help my channel a lot. One of the best features which is available for iOS 14.5 is you can now unlock using the Face ID even when you are wearing a mask. For that you need the Apple Watch to be connected to the phone, and you will be getting a notification on your phone as well as on your Apple Watch. Now the AirTags is visible under the Find My app. So this is how it looks, and you can see the first option is regarding introduction of this AirTags. So this is enabled by default in the 14.5 update. Another new feature is the new color for the couples emoji. So presently I don't use these particular emojis, so y'all can check this out. There are some few new emojis in the iOS 14.5 update, and let me know in the comments below which emoji is your favorite one, and let's see, I may even use it for my next video. One of the most important feature which might be helpful in the future, especially if you are using phones with a 5G capability, is that now the 5G is supported on both the SIM. So it is dual SIM 5G which is now enabled on the iPhone with the 14.5. so this is the iPhone 12 mini which I've already done a lot of videos on it. Please check the link in the description for more videos on the iPhone 12 mini. So guys, Apple have stepped up their games with the privacy setting. Allow apps to request to track is the feature which allows the apps to request you to whether to track them or not. So most of the people get confused with this particular setting. I like to keep it off because this means that none of the apps will allow you to track. So as you can see, if this is enabled, so most of this particular apps will ask you each and every time whether you want to be tracked or not. So I think it is foolish, so I just want to keep this disabled. Let me know in the comments below what you think. So with this particular update iOS 14.5, Apple have actually fixed the battery calibration issue with the older iPhones like iPhone 11, iPhone 10R, etc., where the battery percentage was not showing properly. So if you have this particular update, guys, it will be showing you, you know, accurately. Like sometimes it was dropping for unnecessary reason, or sometimes it was showing slightly above the actual battery percentage, which is being solved in iOS 14.5. There is the good news for all the gamers out playing on the iPhone. The best part is even the PlayStation 5 controllers are now supported on your iPhone. So you all can even connect the third-party accessories and controllers like PlayStation 5 controllers to your iPhone directly. Also guys, the Apple Maps has been updated. So now if there is any accident, etc., now that will be definitely getting updated in your map application itself. Also, I like the UI of the new maps and quite like it. And as you can see over here, there are some new options, etc. Please go and check it out once you install iOS 14.5 update. This is one of the best update for your maps, and definitely it is taking it very big hit. So I had been using the iPhone 12 mini and I had installed the 14.5 update for the past 6 hours, and I had been using this continuously, and till now I didn't find any other issues. Especially the previous version, that is I think 14.2.2, had some lot of issues, like the phone was getting heated, the battery drain, etc. I think these are resolved, and especially the new features which I just discussed, they are awesome, guys. I know most of them might not be useful for everyone, especially the mask ID or whatever you all call it. It is not useful for me because I'm not having an Apple Watch right now with me. So excluding those features, I guess is one of the best update, and definitely you all should update to 14.5. And again guys, thanks a lot for watching this particular video. If you really like this kind of videos, please hit that like button. Please check out our other videos which we have it on our channel by clicking on these particular cards. Also subscribe to this particular channel because we have something new to learn on Creative Soft. Also guys, thanks a lot for watching this particular video till the end, and see you in my next video.